Great, guys. So in this lecture, we'll be looking at how do we add new constraints to a table. Now that we have the students table, if you right click the students table, you can go to edit and this will open up a new dialog box. This is the same dialog box, if you remember, when we go to constraints. If you open this table over here and then go to constraint and click on edit, this is the same dialog box that appears, right? So the same way, in this dialog box we have columns, but we are trying to add new constraints to a table. Now this is the plus sign you can click, and if you click on this one, it allows you to add different types of constraints to your table. Let's take, I want to add a primary key constraint, and this is the primary key. The name is students_pk. It is enabled. And then which column do you want to create this constraint on? So click on student ID, and then if you click on this arrow, this single column will be moved on to this selected columns. Don't click on this double arrow because it will push all the columns from here to this right side. And let's take, you put a wrong column name, then select the column name over here and then you click on this arrow. So this will move this column from a right box to the left box. So now I want to create this primary key on student ID. So I'll select the student ID, click on this arrow, done, and then click on OK. So this new constraint is created. Now, how do you check that constraint? Just click on this table name. It will open the table over here. Go to constraints. And now we should see that primary key constraint over there. Can you see? We have a primary key constraint, and we also have two check constraints. If you remember, while we were creating the table, we mentioned that these two columns should not be null. The student ID should not be null, and also the class should not be null. So that's why we have these two constraints as well. So ultimately, we have a primary key and two check constraints that will check whether the data which is being inputted inside the table is null or not. Now, the same way, if you click on this edit button, because we are under constraints, it opens up the same dialog box. Go to constraints, and then you can click on this button. You can create a unique constraint, you can create a foreign key constraint, you can also create a check constraint. So for now, I'll just click on OK. And at this stage, I would recommend you guys to look at different constraint options inside the SQL developer and try to play around a little bit by creating new constraints inside the tables. That's all for now, guys, and I'll see you in the next lecture.